Hey guys, I thought I would give you guys an update on Aussie, Carrie, and the other animals that live in this room. And I'm going to show you guys like a quick tour of each of their cages and stuff, just to show you guys an update because people have requested that I do an updated little thing on them. Anyway, Aussie is doing wonderful. He is really, really like, sorry, I'm chewing gum, so, yeah. But he's really active and, you know, he has an amazing personality. He's really outgoing. So, yeah. And, I did give him a haircut, like, a few weeks ago, so his hair is really short now. Just because his fur was really long, like you can see in these pictures, you know. Like, his fur was really long. And it was about 7 inches long when I cut it. So I decided, you know, let's just give him a whole haircut so he wouldn't be as much maintenance. And, yeah. So I gave him a haircut. And he's doing really well. Mm-hmm. Aussie. But he's really sweet and everything. But he's just really... He gets shy when the camera comes out. I don't know why, but he just gets really shy. I don't know. But, so yeah, this is his hay rack area. And he already ate all of his food today, so there's no food out there, so. And then he has his favorite tunnel. And then on his cage, I still have Aussie and Dingo on there, you know, just because I really want to keep Dingo, like, his memory. And then I have his sack with the pigs on it and his bed. So, yeah, that's Aussie's cage. And then underneath it I have all of his hay. There's about 9 pounds of hay that I keep in there. And then I have ferret stuff in there. And then over here I have Carrie's cage. As you can tell, I did remove the fence. Here it is right here. But what I did was, I did it because it was taking up so much space and, I mean, since she already has this really, like, it's like the biggest ferret cage you can get, unless you put like two of them together or something, she already has like this really big cage, so why not just let her live in that in the day, or like at night, and during most of the day she lives in there, and then for about 2 hours a day she comes out and she gets to run around the entire room with the fence blocking stuff off. And I mean, ferrets, they sleep 18 to 20 hours a day anyway, so it doesn't really make a difference, because when she's in here she's usually asleep anyway. Hi, Carrie. Mwah. Carrie, come here. Come here, babies. She's so tired. She had her distemper shot today, and then in about 2 weeks, she'll go and get her rabies vaccine, and then she'll be all done for the year. Oh, and she has to have some blood work done, just to check her blood glucose stuff. Oh, Carrie, she's so tired. Mm. You're so sweet. And then this is just like the top level of her cage, and the litter box she has up here. And then she has this stuff, and usually when she's in her cage, she's always asleep. So then on here, she has her hanging hut, and she has some tubes and her food and water dish. And then her square litter box, that's the one that she likes to use best, I don't know why. She just likes that one because it's bigger. And she has her sleeping sack and some toys and stuff. So that's pretty much Carrie's cage. It's the Ferret Nation cage, because I always have people ask me, like, what kind of cage is that in your video? But, yeah, this here is the Ferret Nation cage. It's like called the 142. That's like what the two-story is called. But it's still really nice. And she's stretching. So yeah, that's Carrie's cage, and then Aussie has his cage. Okay, and then over here, this is all the rat stuff, of course. And I have some guinea pig stuff down there. This stuff, this is Aussie's food. Wait. Hold on, let me focus the camera. There we go, it's better. This lighting's like really bad right now. But, that's Aussie's food. And I have like binder clips for the rat's cage. And then, I have the rat's cage, which is the Critter Nation. And on top of them, I have Nadine, the hamster. And the rat's cage, it's all clean and stuff. Fiji and Maui live in here. Hey, Maui. Hi, Maui. And Fiji's in there. And Aussie's going crazy. As always. But Maui's so sweet. Yeah, I don't really want them on my nails though, because I just got my nails done. And they will, like, chew my nails. I don't know why they just like to chew this. They just like to chew the polish off my nails. And, they, like, take all their food and they put it in this hammock, so that's why their food's, like, practically all gone. Then they have, like, the bottom and stuff on their cage. I'm sorry if I'm rambling right now. I'm really tired right now. Aussie, what is your problem? Hmm? Come here, Aussie. Come here. Come here. Come here. Aussie. 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 He's being a butthead. Aussie. Oh, but Carrie looks so cute right now. Look at her. She's so cute. That's nice. You're using your tail as a scarf now. So yeah, that's pretty much everybody in this room. And then all my other guinea pigs are doing really good. So, yeah. Oh, he's grooming himself. So cute. And, so that's pretty much how everybody's doing. And, yeah. You know, if you have any questions, just go to my form to bring or something. And I might be doing a Christmas giveaway where I give something, like a pet supply away to, like, some random subscriber. But I'm not sure if I'm going to do it or not, so... Yeah. So yeah, that's pretty much everything. I'ma bring my girlfriend some